ఫోర్ వన్ సెమిస్టర్కి వచ్చేసరికి ఈసారి సబ్జెక్ట్స్ వచ్చేసి ఫ్లెక్సిబుల్ ఏసీ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ సిస్టమ్ అమ్మ. దీన్ని షార్ట్కట్లో ఫ్యాక్ట్స్ అంటారు. ఫ్లెక్సిబుల్ ఏసీ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ సిస్టమ్, దిస్ ఈస్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ ఇన్ యువర్ 4-1, దట్ మీన్స్ 4th బీటెక్ ఫస్ట్ సెమిస్టర్. ఓకే, ఫ్లెక్సిబుల్ ఏసీ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ సిస్టమ్స్. సో ఇన్ దిస్ సబ్జెక్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఆల్రెడీ యు నో దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ 5 యూనిట్స్ రైట్ ఇన్ ఎవ్రీ సబ్జెక్ట్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ హియర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ నేమ్ ఈస్ ఫ్లెక్సిబుల్ ఏసీ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ సిస్టమ్స్, ఇన్ షార్ట్ కట్ వి కాల్ యాస్ ఫ్యాక్ట్స్, FACTS. Okay. So in this one, the first chapter is concepts of flexible AC transmission systems. Okay. So in the fact subject, the first unit is concepts of flexible AC transmission systems. Okay. Next one. So these are the contents. That means what we are going to discuss those topics is these. First one is introduction. Second topic is transmission line interconnections. Third one is power flow and parallel lines. And fourth one is mesh systems and stability considerations, relative importance of controllable parameters, basic types of FACTS controllers and shunt controller and series controllers and combined shunt and series controllers. And last one is benefits of FACTS. So these are the contents we are going to discuss in the first chapter, that is concepts of flexible AC transmission systems. Okay. All are understanding now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in this subject, first one is introduction. So actual introduction is we have to discuss the basic definition of FACTS, that is flexible AC transmission system. So actually this FACTS, that means flexible AC transmission systems, incorporate power electronic based static controllers. So what is the definition? Flexible AC transmission system incorporate power electronic based static controllers to control the power. That means we have two powers, that is active power and reactive power. Okay, so these two powers we have to control by using incorporating the power electronic based static controllers. And also we have to enhance power transfer capability of the AC lines. So we will mainly focus on AC lines because in the subject name also we have FACTS, that is flexible AC transmission system. So we are mainly focusing on the AC lines in this entire subject. Okay, we will focus on AC lines. That means the definition of FACTS controller, FACTS is flexible AC transmission system incorporate power electronic based static controllers. Okay, incorporate power electronic based static controllers to control power, that means both active and reactive power, and enhance power transfer capability of the AC lines. Okay, this is the basic definition of FACTS. Okay, all are understand? Okay, next one is need for transmission networks interconnections. So here we will mainly focus on some of the points. Those are, first one is to make electric energy generation more economical. So already we discussed in the previous subjects, that means EPTS or EPGS, so electrical energy generation. So here we have to make this electrical energy generation more economical. So for that one, we have to site the generating stations, whatever it is. That is, generating stations means we have different generating stations we are having for the electrical energy. So those are hydroelectric power plants, and next one is nuclear power plants and thermal power plants. Many are there. So by using these generating stations are sited remotely from the load centers. We have to situate the generating stations remotely from the load centers. Load centers means what is meant by load center? So load center is the utilizing center. Okay, utilized center and closer to the source of power, and mainly focus on this one. That means closer to the source of power. We have to situate the generating stations remotely from the load centers and closer to the source of power so we have different sources of power. That means if you want to generate the electrical energy from the hydro power plant, we have to use what is the source of power? Water. And we have to generate electrical energy from the nuclear power plant. So what is the source of power? Nuclear energy. So by using thermal power plants, what is the source of power? Water or coal. Okay, coal. So these are the sources of power to generate the electrical energy from different generating stations. So all are understanding, na? Okay, first point, what is okay. So I am discussing about the need for transmission networks. Okay, the need for transmission networks interconnections. Okay, transmission network interconnections. So in this one, first one is to make electric energy generation more economical. So we have to get the electrical energy as more economical means we have to situate the generating stations remotely from the load centers and closer to the source of power. Okay, and next one is so for example, here we have an example to explain, to neatly understanding the first point. That is, for example, the primary concern to the hydroelectric power plant is the availability of water. We are all very known about this point. Okay, so the primary concern to the hydroelectric power plant is the availability of water. Okay, and benefits of the sites having higher heights with significant water flows. So I already discussed it in the subject EPGS, electrical power generating systems. Okay, here in that subject I discussed about hydroelectric power plant, nuclear power plant, thermal power plants, all are. Okay, so on that subject I discussed about these higher head positions, lower head positions, medium head positions, right? Okay, so if you want, the primary concern to hydroelectric power plant is the availability of water and benefits of the sites having higher heads with significant water flows. So the main concern to the hydroelectric power plant is the availability of water. So we have to utilize that water, means we have to storage that water like in the manner of reservoir, or by using the heads, that means higher heads, lower heads and medium heads. By using those, we have to store the water flows. Okay, while thermoelectric power plants are situated near to coal mines, because the primary concern to the thermoelectric power plant is the availability of coal. That means we have to situate the thermoelectric power plant nearer to the coal mines. And coming to the nuclear power plants, so what is the primary concern for the nuclear power plants? Gas, nuclear gas. Okay, so actually the main concern of nuclear power plant is these are situated distantly away from the urban centers for safety. That is the main reason, because of safety purpose we have to situate the nuclear power plant away from the populated areas. So we are already known about these things. Okay, yes or no? We are already known these things about hydro power plant, about thermoelectric power plant, about nuclear power plant. Okay, so next point is here the transmission lines serves the purpose to pool the generating sites and load centers covering large distances between generation and end users in order to minimize the total generation. That means we have to pull the generating sites because of, and at the same time load centers also, because to cover the large distances between generation and end users. Okay, so our main aim to decrease the electrical energy cost. Okay, generation cost. So for that one I am taking this one, transmission lines. So these are used to serve the purpose to pool the generating sites and load centers covering large distances between generation and end users. End users means our. Okay, we are all the end users. Okay, because we are all using the electrical energy, right? We are all using the electrical energy means we are the end users. So because in order to minimize the total generation capacity and their cost. Okay, total generation capacity alage dana vaadi yokka cost man tagichali ante compulsory ga mana transmission lines ni use cheskovali. Okay, all are understanding why we are using transmission lines means to serve the purpose to pool the generating sites and load centers, generating sites and load centers covering large distances between generation and end users in order to minimize the total generation capacity and the cost. Okay, so coming to next slide, so here one more point is there. So to enhance the system reliability, so the electric power supply systems are widely interconnected. So we have to focus on the system reliability. So to focus on system reliability, we have to check, is the electric power supply systems are widely interconnected or not. Okay, we have to check, is the power supply systems are widely interconnected or not. So here the interconnected means interlinking the neighboring power supply utilities. That means interlinking the neighboring power supply utilities. Okay, so which further extend to inter-regional and international connections. So interconnection nothing but is interlinking the neighboring power supply utilities, which further extended to inter-regional and international connections. Okay, so we have to check or enhance the system reliability. So for that one, we have to focus on the electric power supply systems are widely interconnected or not. So if the electric power supply systems are widely interconnected, so that means interlinking the neighboring power supply utilities, that means wherever we are taking the power supply, so those are the neighboring power supply utilities. So which further extended to inter-regional and international connections. Okay, and next point is, moreover, with the probable unavailability of some generating units, so we have this disadvantage in every electrical power generating station, that is the unavailability of the units, generating units, that means water, coal, anything. So we have to check the availability of these generating units. And then the interconnection lines could force the electric power flows to be redirected through longer routes to provide emergency assistance. That means whenever we have the unavailability of generating units, that means we have the lack of the sources. So if we have the lack of the sources to generate the electrical energy in a specific station, we have, that is the emergency assistance. Okay, that is emergency assistance. So that means when encountering partial blackouts, that means we have that is a disconnection of the power or disconnection of any unit, a damage of any unit detectors, that is the main problem whenever the availability of the resources are less. So one more thing is also there, that is transmission interconnections enable taking benefit of diversity of loads. So for example, take thermal electric power plant. So here the main source of the electrical energy generation is coal. So we have the unavailability of generating units in the station, so we have to use transmission interconnections. By using these interconnections, we have to divert the loads. That means we have some electrical energy is in the thermal power plant before shorting of the sources. Okay, so whenever we are situating the lack of the sources, means we have to divert the loads. That means we have to shift the loads to the another areas. Okay, not delivering same generating energy to the same station, same end user. We have to distribute those loads into different different end users. That is the main use of the transmission interconnections. So by using transmission interconnections, we have to enable the diversity of loads. Okay, availability of sources and fuel price. Okay, to provide the interrupted service to the loads. So that is the main aim of the transmission interconnections, to deliver the uninterrupted services to the loads. Okay, we have to deliver the uninterrupted services to the loads. Okay, are you understanding? Okay, we have to deliver the uninterrupted services to the loads by using transmission interconnections, by enabling the benefits of diversity of loads, okay, and at the same time availability of sources and fuel price. Okay, so these are the main concerns to provide the uninterrupted services to the loads. Okay, that is the need for transmission interconnections. Okay, transmission line interconnections, that is the first topic in our subject. That means in the first unit of the FACTS, flexible AC transmission systems. Okay, so next topic is need for FACTS devices. So why we go to the FACTS devices means here we have some points to discuss. So first one is, as power transfer goes, we are already know about the in the present scenario, the power transfer is growing day by day. Okay, so means if the power transfer grows, means the generation of electrical energy is also grows or increasing. Okay, so here the first point is, as power transfers grow, the power system becomes increasingly more complex. Okay, the power system becomes increasingly more complex to operate. Why? Because this power system becomes increasingly more complex means to operate, and the system can become less secure. Okay, whenever the power transfer grows, means the power system becomes increasingly more complex to operate, and the system can become less secure for riding through the major outages. So outages means whenever the system is collapsed, or whenever the unavailability of the sources. So these are the things to the outages in the generating plants. Okay, so here the first point is, as power transfers grow, the power system becomes increasingly more complex to operate, and the system can become less secure for riding through the major outages. Okay, so if the system is become less secure, means it may lead to large power flows with inadequate control. So there is no control in the flow of the power. So that means it may lead to large power flows with inadequate control. At the same time, we have excessive reactive power in various parts of the system. Excessive reactive power in various parts of the system. At the same time, large dynamic swings between different parts of the system and bottlenecks. These are occurred when the large power flows with inadequate control. Okay, so if we have the less secure, the system is less secure, means we have to ride through the major outages. So it may lead to the large power flows with inadequate control and excessive reactive power in various parts of the system and large dynamic swings between different parts of the system and bottlenecks. So, and thus the full potential of transmission interconnections cannot be utilized. So in the previous concept, we discussed about need for transmission interconnections. So in that one, we discussed about some generating stations. So here in that one, we have to use the electrical energy generation more economical. So for that one, we discussed some examples. Okay, so whenever these situations occurs, we do not use the full potential of transmission interconnections. Okay, so for that one, the power systems of today by and large are mechanically controlled. Actually, so we are already known that today's power systems are largely mechanically controlled. Okay, not an automatically controlled. So for that one, so even though we use up microelectronics, computers and high speed communications for control and production of power transmission systems. Okay, so in this scenario, we have to operate mechanically, but in that one also we use microelectronics, computers and high speed communications for control and production of present transmission systems. So however, the final power control action is taken by the mainly by the stations and all. Okay, so this is the need for power FACTS control, some points, and few more points is also there. That is, so also the mechanical devices is that control cannot be initiated frequently. So already I said that one point in the previous slide, that is, so the power systems of today by and large are mechanically controlled, okay? So by using this one, so the mechanical devices is that control cannot be initiated frequently. So we have to use the mechanical devices frequently. So if we don't initiate the mechanical devices frequently, they tend to wear out very quickly compared to static devices. Okay. Also, the mechanical devices is that control cannot be initiated frequently. Okay, mechanical devices is that control cannot be initiated frequently because they tend to wear out very quickly compared to the static devices. And one more point is also there, that is increased demands on transmission. Okay, increased demands on transmission, absence of long-term planning, and the need to provide open access to generating companies and customers all together have created tendencies means difficulties, okay, all together have created difficulties toward less security and reduced quality of supply. Okay, so these are occurred mainly increased demands of transmission. So those points are absence of long term planning. So the human nature is short-term planning only, or temporarily planning. So not for long-term planning. So this is the main reason is to increase the demands on transmission and the need to provide open access to generating companies and customers. So up to now we don't give the open access to generating companies and customers also. All together have created tendencies towards less security. Altogether have created tendencies toward less security and reduced quality of supply. So our main aim is to produce the electrical energy to the customers in a good quality and give the electrical power generation very economical manner. Okay, that is our main aim. Okay, so to overcome these difficulties, we are using here PACS technology. So here the PACS technology is essential to alleviate some but not all of these difficulties. Okay, whatever we discussed in the previous points, so to overcome some of those points we have to use the PACS technology. Okay, not all points, some of the points. Okay, so the PACS technology is essential to alleviate some but not all of these difficulties by enabling utilities to get more service from the transmission facilities and enhance grid reliability. Okay, so if we use the PACS technology to overcome the before the previously discussed points, so by enabling utilities to get the most service from the transmission facilities and enhance grid reliability. Okay, so these are the need for PACS devices, and a few more points is also there. So those are the PACS concept originally came into effect in 1980s. So actually we are discussing the PACS technology in this subject, but we have this PACS technology in the earlier 1980s also. Okay, so the PACS concept originally came into effect in 1980s to solve operation problems due to the restrictions on the construction of new transmission lines, okay, to improve power system stability margins. So in 1980s the PACS concept is originally came into effect. Okay, why? Because to solve the operation problems due to the restrictions on the construction of new transmission lines. Okay, due to the restrictions on the construction of new transmission lines, at the same time to improve power system stability margins. Okay, to improve power system stability margins. Okay, and it also facilitates power exchange between different generating companies. Okay, it also facilitates power exchange between different generation companies and large power users. Okay, so for example, I am one user and I am the one user, and another, you are the one user, means you are all the one user and I am the one user. So if you want to exchange the power okay, between different generating companies and large power users, so thus considerably utilizing the existing transmission network. Okay. So if you want to exchange the power between different generating companies and large power users, so thus considerably utilizing the existing transmission network instead of adding new transmission lines for growing demand of power. Okay. So if you want to exchange the power between different generating companies and large power users, considerably utilizing the existing transmission network instead of adding new transmission lines for the growing demand of power, so as it may be restricted due to economical and environmental problems. Okay. And one more point, FACTS controllers can control the interrelated parameters. Okay, interrelated parameters means to govern the operation of transmission systems. That means those are including series impedance, shunt impedance, current, voltage, phase angle, and damping of oscillations at various frequencies below the rated frequency. So we are all very known about the rated frequency in India. That is 50 hertz. So we have to control the interrelated parameters by using FACTS controllers. So these are used to govern the operation of transmission systems, including series impedance, shunt impedance, current, voltage, phase angle, and the damping of oscillations at various frequencies below the rated frequency. Okay. So next, so these constraints cannot be overcome. So whatever we discussed, so these constraints cannot be overcome while maintaining the required system reliability. So while maintaining the required system reliability by mechanical means without lowering the usable transmission capacity. Okay. So these constraints cannot be overcome while maintaining the required system reliability by mechanical means without lowering the usable transmission capacity. So next one is, FACTS controllers can enable a line. So FACTS controllers can enable a line to carry power closer to its thermal rating. So FACTS controllers can enable a line to carry power closer to its thermal rating. And the next one is mechanical switching. So mechanical switching means physical appearance of the human being. Okay, mechanical switching needs to be supplemented by rapid response power electronics. Okay, mechanical switching needs to be supplemented by rapid response power electronics. So we have to change the mechanical switching into the rapid response power electronics. Okay, so that means we have to change the technology. So next one is, the FACTS technology is not a single high power controller. So whatever we are discussing about FACTS technology, so it is not a single high power controller. Okay. It is not a single high power controller, but rather a collection of controllers. So it is a collection of controllers. Okay. So which can be applied individually. So this FACTS technology can be applied individually or in coordination with others. So for this point only, I told about you that in the definition of the FACTS controllers. So the FACTS controller is a interrelation of power electronic devices. Okay. So here the main point is, the FACTS technology is not a single high power controller, but rather a collection of controllers. So which can be applied individually or in coordination with others to control one or more of the interrelated systems. Okay, interrelated parameters. So already we discussed about interrelated parameters. Those are series impedance, shunt impedance, current, voltage, power, and so on, under the rated frequency only. Okay. So by using the FACTS technology, so we have to note the point is, the FACTS technology is not a high power controller, not a single high power controller. It is a combination of, that means collection of controllers. Okay. So which can be applied individually or in coordination with others to control one or more of the interrelated system parameters. Okay, so this is the today's topic. Okay, so here in this class I discussed about introduction about the facts, that means concepts of facts controllers in the first unit. Okay, so I discussed about concept of facts controllers, that includes definition of facts, that is the introduction. And in the introduction also I discussed about need for transmission interconnections and need for facts devices. Okay,